Good morning guys and welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to talk about the traditional water harvesting systems of Rajasthan. So let's begin with the introduction part over here. It says Rajasthan is located in the northwestern region of India and once constituted of the number of princely states. The arid desert is situated in the far west of Rajasthan, but there is a habitable and fertile tract in the northeast. Okay, habitable means where the people can live. Cultivation is naturally a precarious in the arid region. Now, what is the precarious? Is precarious is an adjective, okay, which means which is something which is dangerous and not safe. However, there are some well-built towns like Jodhpur, Jaisalmer, okay, in this region. The Luni River rises in the Aravali, okay, which river? That is Luni River rises in the Aravali hills and flows from Ajmer to run off Kutch. Okay, this kind of question only they ask. They picked up these names and then they put. Thus, draining of the large part of the arid zone. The region receives around 1,525 mm to 1,780 mm rainfall annually. Thus, irrigation is restricted to the deep wells and rainwater harvesting system. Water harvesting thus is deeply rooted in social fabric of Rajasthan. Since Rajasthan is a region where there is no perennial. And what is the meaning of the word perennial? Perennial means everlasting. And here it is opposite of that. Is no perennial means that most of the rivers are not everlasting. They get dried. They are kind of seasonal rivers. Okay. So most water related problems are related to the fluctuating weather and river system. Nearly all the natural resources of water, like your jharnas, that is called your springs in English, have some mythological origin. Okay, so most of the water bodies are somehow associated with some kind of mythological stories, right? Now it says, like for example, your Ban Gangas, it emerges from the place where the Pandavas are said to be lived. Okay, so now in the question they can ask you in this form also, okay, which place is associated with the Pandavas. Okay, so then this option they can give you these names in it, right? Now it says Bhimgoda is a place where the Bhima pressed his knees to the earth to send the water gushing out of it. Okay, now water is so scarce in Rajasthan that the source of natural water has become a place of pilgrimage for most people. Okay, now if we talk about the types of water bodies, that how many types of water bodies are there in Rajasthan. So in Rajasthan there are the various traditional water sources systems, okay, such as your Nadi, Talab, Johad, Bandh, Sagar, Samand and Sarovar. Wells are another important source of water. The different types of wells are found in Rajasthan. Kua is a local name for it. Kua is usually a well owned by an individual, that is called a kua. The large wells are known as your called kohar. Okay, these are your what? Large wells are known as called kohar. They may give you the option like this. The large wells are called dash. And the four option may be kua, kohar and johad, sagar, whatever. So then you have to pick it up. So you need to remember that large wells are called kohar and are rarely owned by the community. Usually owned by the communities. The step wells are known as your bawli. Okay, step wells, where the steps are there, right, to get into the water and people collect the water from it. They are known as called your bawlis. Okay, and they are usually constructed as a good deed performed to obtain punya. Okay, so why these bawlis are constructed, why they are made to get punya. Okay, another name for bawli is your jhalara. Okay, the most primitive step well might probably dated back to your 550 AD. However, the most illustrious steps wells are constructed in the medieval period. It is roughly estimated that more than 3000 step wells were constructed in two major northern states of India. Okay, further it says the step wells are known by different names. Okay, they have the different name, such as what? Bawdi. Then now the Bawdi can be spoken or written in different ways here. That is the Bawdi, Bawri, Bawli, Bawdi. And this like this way about you, okay. They were developed as a response to the huge variations in the availability of water supply. A step well makes it easier to reach the groundwater level and to also maintain the well. Another type of step well known as your johara, okay, this is also a type of step well, was developed with the ramps so that the cattle could reach the water easily. Okay, so johara is like a kind of wells which are specially meant for cattle to drink water in it. Okay, it is approachable by even by the cattle or the animals. Now these step wells had a unique system of water harvesting. द ह्यूज ओपन सरफेस ऑफ वेल एक्टेड एज द रेन कैचिंग ओके कंड्यूट टू कलेक्ट द वाटर एंड कंसाइंड इट टू द बॉटम ऑफ द वेल द सिस्टम ऑफ स्टेप वेल्स वॉज मेंट टू एंश्योर दैट पीपल हैड डायरेक्ट एक्सेस टू द वाटर थ्रू आउट द ईयर सो दिस वॉज वॉट इट्स पर्पज वॉज दैट वाई द स्टेप वेल्स वर मेड फॉर ओके दे ऑल्सो सर्व द आर्किटेक्चरल पर्पज नाउ वॉट काइंड ऑफ आर्किटेक्चरल पर्पज दे आर सॉल्विंग आई टेल यू दैट देर इज इन सैन फ्रांसिस्को और समवेयर लाइक इन यू एस आई डोंट रिमेंबर एग्जैक्टली द नेम ऑफ द प्लेस बट दे हैव टेकन द डिजाइन ऑफ द इंडियन स्टेप वेल्स एंड दे हैव क्रिएटेड अ बिग शॉपिंग मॉल ओवर देयर ओके इन द सेम डिजाइन एंड द पैटर्न सो दैट्स वाई इट इज मेंशन ओवर हियर दैट द आर्किटेक्चरल पर्पज डिजाइन ऑफ दिस इज सच Okay, now further we have the architecture of the step well. So they are been divided into the two types. Okay, there are two common types of it. Okay, of step well. The first one is the step pond with a large mouth apex and modified sides that meets at the modality and profundity. The next one, okay, the second type is the next one would be the actual step well category that generally includes a tapered shaft guarded from the direct sunbeams from the full or the partial covering that ends with a curved or profound well end. Alright, so many of the step wells are painted with lime-based paint. Okay, what kind of paint were used? That was lime-based paint. Different types of permeable colors are also used. Okay, so now one by one we will discuss about all these traditional methods of harvesting. So first one, water harvesting, sorry. So first one is about Chand Bhavri in Abhineri village. Okay, so Chand Bhavri in Abhineri village is one of the primitive step wells in the state of Rajasthan and is thought to be one of the largest. Okay, it appears exactly like a well and there are 3,500 tapered steps. Okay, now what is this word tapered here means? The taper is actually derived from the word called taper, okay, which is a verb and it means to become gradually narrow, okay, like something which become gradually narrow like this, okay, so this is getting narrower, right? So these are tapered steps in the step well. The green water at the base of the well indicates that the well is no longer used. Okay, the steps encircles the steps well on the three sides, while the fourth side has a group of pavilions that are constructed on the top of the other. The famous Chand Bhavri at Abhinar was featured in the movie called The Fall, okay, and another called The Dark Knight Rises. It was featured in that movies also. At present, this step well is one of the vital assets of the country and is administered by the Archaeological Survey of India. Now in the series we have Bundi Kota. So Bundi is a beautiful town and important in the history of Rajasthan. It is surrounded by Aravali hills on the three sides and a massive wall with four gateways. Okay, how many gateways it has? Four gateways are there. Famous for the intricate carvings and mural. Now what these murals are? Murals are it's a painting on the large walls. Okay, so Bundi is famous for it. So Bundi is known for its bowries or the step wells constructed by royalty and affluent member of the society. This served the water reservoirs when there was a scarcity of water. The finest example is Ranjiki, okay, which was built by Rani Nathavati ji in 1699 AD. Okay, they may ask you that when this, they give you the name and when this was constructed and by whom it was constructed. This may the question may be put during her son Buddha Singh's time. It is adorned with finely sculptured pillars and arcs. It is a multi-storied structure with places of worship on each floor. The steps built into the side of the water well made water accessible even when at a very low level. In Bundi, there are about 86 bowries to collect water. After the monsoon, these bowries get filled up with water. The street channels the run over the water from one tank to the other. The deepest steep well is about 46 meters deep. Okay, now next we have Karj Kund, or we call it Tulsi Kund, which is located at Eklingji Temple at Udaipur. So these kunds are situated near 15th century AD Jain temple situated in the town of Eklingji. The water is utilized for the rituals in the temple, especially at Eklingji rituals of Lord Shiva. The two artificial pools have been created in the temple of Galtazi and in Jaipur district. The water is collected in 7 tanks. The holiest being is the Galtakund, which never became dry. Okay, this is the quality of this. Okay, another temple complex in Jaipur is the Ram Gopalji temple. Okay, also known as your monkey temple. They may ask you this question also, which temple is known as called a monkey temple, so that also you need to remember it, right? There is a cluster of sacred kunds near the temple complex. Now there is another place, and that place is known as called your Kuman in Bharatpur district of Rajasthan. Is an old sacred town of Hindus and forms the part of bridge area where the Lord Krishna spent his early life. Okay, so Kuman also has around 84 kunds, water kunds, many of which have dried up. It was long ruled by Maharajas of Jaipur. Okay, during the rainy season, a fair is held called here Parikrama Mela. Okay, and Parikrama Mela is held during rainy season. All right. The next one is at the Naval Sagar Lake, which is situated in Bundi, and is an artificial lake built in the form of a square. Okay, square shape. It contains many tiny isles. The temple of Lord Varuna, the Vedic god of water, is situated in the middle of the lake. Okay, the Dhabi Kund, also known as Jail Kund, is the largest and the most historical kund of the Bundi district. Okay, there are many steps leading down to the water level. Okay, now ancient surface water bodies have been in the news for many hundreds of years. They are excellent examples of the architectural and engineering design, even, right? And were built on the principles of community sharing. An unwritten code maintained this water system for many centuries. Okay, however, with the introduction of public water supply, these ancient water bodies have gone into the decline. Okay, the next one we have the nadis. So nadis are village ponds. Actually, they are known as called nadis. They are constructed in the valley by strategically building earthen embankments across the natural depression. These nadis are mostly found in your Jodhpur and Rajasthan district of Rajasthan. They may ask you, right? They may give you the option with these options, like which district they are found in, right? You need to remember that is Jodhpur and Rajasthan. They are used for storing water for an adjoining natural catchment during the rainy season. The site is selected by the villagers based on the available natural catchments and their water yield potentials. Water availability from the nadi ranges from 2 months to a year. Okay, this much long they can store the water in it. Okay, after the rains. Okay, in the dunes area, they range from 1.5 to 4.0 meters. Okay, that is in dune areas. Okay, and in sandy plains from 3 to 12 meters. The location of nadi depends on its storage capacity due to the related catchment and turn off. Okay, now what the mostly the nadis are required. Nadis are mostly required for your kettles. However, the 1/3 of the nadis have been badly polluted due to the absence of maintenance. Due to the large surface area of the nadis, there is heavy water loss from evaporation. Guys, next we have talabs. Now the talabs are otherwise known as the lakes or the large reservoirs. Okay, constructed in the natural depression of valleys, they are traditionally constructed by the villagers on community lands. Okay, using lime masonry walls on the sides with the soil as the filling material between the walls. Now, some talabs have wells also close to in their beds. For example, the Kharasan talab. Okay, was a historically important water harvesting structure, and it was constructed by an earthen embankment on the downstream side of the curvature on the upstream side of the given more strength to the structure. Now, talabs are famous in the Mewar regions, especially. Okay, in which region? Mewar region, and the city of Udaipur has a large number of talabs there. Okay, hence it was named as Lake City. So this is the reason why Udaipur is known as called your Lake City, because of the large number of talabs over there. The reservoirs are in the various size and named as variously. Okay, at different places the talabs have the different names that we will see over here, that what names are given to the talabs over here. A small lake is called your talai. स्मॉल लेक ओके, ए मीडियम साइज लेक इज कॉल्ड योर बांध और तालाब ओके, एंड ए बिगर वन इज नोन इज कॉल्ड योर सागर और समंद ओके. वाटर फ्रॉम दिस रिजर्वियर्स इज यूज फॉर द ड्रिंकिंग एज वेल एज फॉर द इरीगेशन पर्पज. ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ तालाब्स आर लॉस्ट ड्यू टू द अर्बेनाइजेशन एंड इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन ओके. अर्लियर दे यूज टू सर्व द ड्रिंकिंग नीड्स ऑफ द कम्युनिटी ऑफ द पीपल ओके. तो दिस इज ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ओवर हियर. दिस नेम्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट गाइज, यू नीड टू सी दिस प्रॉपरली ऑल राइट, बिकॉज दिस नेम मे बी आस्क ओवर हियर राइट. सो दे मे आस्क यू दैट वांस इज बांध तालाब एंड दिस सागर समंद एंड तलाई एंड राइट काइंड ऑफ ओके. नेक्स्ट वी आर द टैंक्स. हियर वी डोंट फाइंड एक्चुअली मच मोर इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग हियर. द टैंक्स आर मोस्टली कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन द जोधपुर एरिया राइट, दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर हियर, नथिंग मोर. दे आर कंस्ट्रक्ट द टैंक्स इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट टू तालाब्स आर कंस्ट्रक्टेड विद ह्यूज मशीनरी वॉल्स ऑन द फोर साइड्स ओके. दे आर शेप वेन वी टॉक अबाउट दे आर स्क्वेयर और रेक्टेंगुलर इन द शेप एंड कैन होल्ड द मैसिव अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर राइट. सो देर इज नथिंग मोर इन द टैंक्स ओवर हियर राइट. वी गो अहेड विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. Okay, if we'll have a quick look at the Bawris. Now, what these Bawris are? So Bawris are the community wells actually found in Rajasthan, and they are used mainly for drinking purpose, and they are built by the Banjaras, that is a nomadic communities, okay, for drinking need. They can hold the water for the long time because of almost negligible water evaporation, means there is very less water evaporation in it. Okay, they do not have any catchment area of their own, nor are they connected to any water course. They assess the water from the seepage of talab or the lake situated nearby it. Okay, they occupy minimum space in order to save money, time and energy. Jodhpur is especially famous for the Bawris. Okay, there is very little water evaporation from the Bawris compared to the other water bodies. The condition of half of the Bawris is fairly good, while the remaining requires maintenance. Okay, next we have called Jhalaras. Okay, now what these Jhalaras are? These are the man-made tanks essentially used for community bathing. What was their purpose? That was community bathing and religious function also. They are rectangular in design, okay, and have steps on three or four sides. Okay, they collect your subterranean. Okay, here the word is used, subterranean. Now you need to see this word here, subterranean. Now what is this subterranean means? We are talking in the sense of your underground water. Okay, so they're kind of underground subterranean seepage or talab or the lake situated upstream. An outstanding example of this Mahamandir Jhalar, which was constructed in 1660. Okay, next we have Tobas. Now it's a very very traditional name also, typical Rajasthani name. The Tobas is local name given a ground depression with a natural catchment area. What this Tobas are? A hard plot of land with low porosity consisting of a depression and a natural catchment area was selected for the construction of Tobas. It provides water for human and livestock consumption, okay, and a grass growing around it provide the pasture for the cattle. Okay, it ordered to preserve and enlarge the capacity of the Tobas. The catchment area were widened. No encroachment was allowed to damage the catchment. The Tobas are also deepened to increase the storage capacity. Okay, next we have the kunds. Okay, so the kunds are the rainwater harvesting structure found in the sandier tracts. Okay, now what is the sandier? Sandier is actually comparative degree of the word sandy. Okay, sandy, then we have sandier. Okay, and the superlative degree of that is your sandiest. Okay, so it is sandier tract of the Thar Desert in western Rajasthan. Which part? In the western Rajasthan. They dot the region and are the main source of the drinking water. Okay, I forget to tell you the meaning of the word sandier. Sandier means which is covered with or containing lot of sand. It is also meaning a light yellow color. Okay, but here in the sense of sand there. So a kund is a circular underground water well. It looks like a saucer-shaped catchment area. Now, saucer-shaped, okay? Saucer is like the plate in which you drink your chai or something, right? Like this. Okay, so that is the saucer-shaped. It is catchment area which gently slopes towards the center where the well or the kund is situated. The depth and the diameter of the kunds may depend on the requirement of the water used for drinking and domestic purposes. The sides of the well pit are covered with lime and ash. Most pits are covered by a lid to protect the water. The kunds may be owned by rich businessmen and landlords, especially during the period of Mahabharata, right? This place had around 84 kunds, okay, associated with an equal number of tirthas. Okay, all have now disappeared due to the encroachment. However, the kunds are very essential in that the importance of the kunds with the respect to the recharge of the aquifers and recognition in the low-lying regions of the Rajasthan. These kunds are actually owned by the community and sometimes built by the community corporation before the starting of the monsoon. The catchment area of the kund is regularly cleaned, especially in the Thar Desert. These kunds serve the important purpose of providing drinking water requirement for far-flung settlement. The kund are by and large circular in shape with diameter ranging from 3 meter to 4.5 meter. Lime plaster or the cement is used in the construction of the kunds. The catchment area varies from 250 square meter to 2 hectare areas. Alright, so this is all about your kunds. Okay, the next we have your tankas. Okay, now what is tankas? Tankas are the small tanks are traditionally found in the main house or in the courtyard of the Bikaner house. Okay, or the houses. It is an underground tank. Okay, with circular holes made in the ground, lined with the fine polished lime where the rainwater is collected. Often the tanks are beautifully decorated with the tiles which help to keep the water cool. Okay, this water is used only for the drinking purpose. The tank system is also found in pilgrim towns like Dwarka in Gujarat, okay, where they have been in existence for centuries. Alright guys, so this way we have discussed with all the traditional water harvesting system of Rajasthan. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope and I pray this video will prove helpful for you from your exam point of view. Thank you very much and have a nice day ahead. Bye bye.